Hello internet, we are back for vlog number 15. We're getting ready to go to Puerto Rico. I just got some bike work finished up this morning, fresh chain, fresh brake pads, lubed up the pulleys and pivots and everything else. And now I need to go get a COVID test so they let me into the country, which I guess is technically part of the US.
Oh yeah, she's looking good. She's looking good. Later we're gonna put some fresh Maxxis tires on her.
All right, time to get tested.
Explanation here is that you need a PCR result, obviously negative, from within 72 hours of travel to A, get into Puerto Rico, which is the main thing. And you also need a negative test to get into the Olympic bubble there.
Now, time to go ride.
Stay down the bike. Time to hit a couple sets of intervals. Get back and keep packing and organizing.
Two intervals down, woo, two to go. Need a little pick me up.
Step one after you finish a ride is to immediately go for whatever carbohydrate is readily available. My roommate's animal crackers, sorry Brad. A loaf of bread, some cookies,
eventually some recovery drink.
Maybe you're too boxed to take your helmet off, maybe you're not.
Court time.
Jamming some leftover Englewood grass-fed beef burritos.
They just launched their beef subscription box, so go check that out.
So in my mega package palooza, we got some new Castelli items and a new vest, some D's nuts, and some Stans raised sealants. Super stoked to be working with Stans this year, so no flats.
I also got a package from ESI Grips. So I'm super stoked to be working with them for the sixth year in a row. I love my Fit CR grips and their RCT wrap for my road bike and stuff.
I just hit some arms and core on the gym with Coach G. Now I'm gonna hit some recovery.
And then we're going to mount up some race tires.
All right, we have our negative test, so we're good to go. And I just submitted a form declaring my whereabouts as well as a negative test to the Puerto Rican government.
Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been.
All right, my bike is packed. I've had too much coffee, and now it's time to go do my intervals.
Fun fact, you can put name stickers on your glasses cases, and they stay really well.
For Puerto Rico, I'm bringing the Speedcrafts and the Speedcraft SLs with photochromatic lenses. Sorry, Hypercrash, you're staying home.
I always bring two pairs of glasses when I race and two pairs of shoes because stuff happens that I've personally broken glasses at a race and then I had to borrow some.
Well, this is definitely an airport hotel.
I can finally take my mask off. 8 hours later.
It's time to put shorts on.
Dex, show us your dinner.
Dinner of champions. Half of a mushy banana.
All right, Dax, serve it up. What do we got back here?
Oh, what can I get you?
Can you pick in the water? We don't know if we're adhering to that stereotype.
Tastes good.
If the water's bad or good, it just depends on how it tastes, regardless of the bacteria.
They're good microbes, he says. Good microbes. We got some palm trees. We got Dax. Everything's loaded up. Now we're going to Salinas, where the race in the Olympic Park is.
Oh, that's good.
All right, we got the dorm. Ooh.
All right, she's all cafeteria style. We don't know what we're eating.
It really brings me back to my glory days.
High school grind.
We also don't know enough Spanish for this.
Well, we made it to Puerto Rico.
think all right.
Got a little traffic on the course here, a couple of horses.
What in the?
All right, more rice, beans, and chicken, but this time with a wonderful sunset.
Worse, but I can't tell if that's what it is or if it's some big gnarly thing.
You gonna pit it?
So. All right, Dax, breakfast review. What do you think?
A 69 out of 420. not the best.
They're nice.
Oh yeah, we're going to the beach, Daxton. AKA our recovery spin. All right, found the ocean. Woo, not bad. We found ourselves a beach. Oh yeah, we wandered our way to a beach. Steve,
we found the beach.
Did some swimming, did some dunking.
Got some salt in my ears.
We're very, very crusty boys. Interpret that as you may. The mega aloe size of this.
The big girl.
Oh my goodness.
Oh boy.
Oh.
Alright, well it's day four.
Day four.
We've eaten enough rice and beans to kill a horse. And now we just have oats and peanut butter for breakfast now.
Oh, Elsa. Paul and I are out warming up for pre-ride and our openers, and we just saw a horse in the back of a pickup truck. Yeah.
Pre-ride is done. Paul and I are tanning up nicely, and it's really hot out. Time to pin up some numbers. First pinning since Cyclocross Worlds in 2020.
So we made our entire breakfast with a coffee pot. Dax, show us your mug. Oh yeah, Carson, show us your mug. How's your mug level, Carson? Oh, it's a bowl.
We got the gourmet pre-race peanut butter sandwich meal.
Time to go race some bikes. I don't have anybody taking any videos, so I don't know. You'll see something after this of me doing something.
Yeah, just a little bit dusty out there.
I'm going to interject a post hoc race report here, even though I'm back in Indianapolis.
Yeah, so I started like 65th. I was 8th to last for the first corner out of 75. And just moved up the entire race, finished 17th, first U23 American, 5th American overall, and I think 4th overall U23. All right, we gotta roll down to the shooting range at the Olympic Center to do our COVID testing if we fail.
We have serving number like 30 of rice and beans, but with plantains and fish, and yeah, we're not sick of it yet. Also lasagna.
This is how we make breakfast. We use our coffee pot, hot water, to make our oats in our coffee.
Got a 45 minute climb, headed by the Wisco Disco.
Yeah.
Mystery adventure.
We're out here in the jungle on top of a mountain,
and it's legitimate rainforest. Like, think of the smell when you walk into the rainforest exhibit at the zoo.
Tourist stand all the way over there.
Got the mini mart, got the fresh bananas. The boys.
Yeah, so we just did 3 hours, 40 miles, up a mountain, through a rainforest. It was awesome.
All right, we have completed our gym workout. Oh yeah, all the boys, looking swell. All
right, this is Paul and I are on day, I don't know, 7 of eating basically only oatmeal, rice, and beans, and coffee, and our stomachs are really confused now.
All right, Paul and I are going to pre-ride, dialing some lines, hit a hot lap, and get things together for Sunday. Wait, no, Saturday. Yeah.
Woo! That's bad. All right, it's 8:30 in the morning. Paul and I are gonna go spin and do the same road for the umpteenth time. Yeah, 2 days out from race day.
We are out here in the jungle again. Spinning it up. Easy peasy.
Morning. It is 8 a.m. I am out on my bike already, which is a record. To hit my course preview time. Do a couple openers and get everything else dialed for tomorrow.
All right, we got another brain tickle test done. And I don't know, we definitely won't have these before the race tomorrow, but they have results.
There's some over there. Mystery blue stripe?
All right. What in the hell? Last day of making Boy Scout camp breakfast. We're ready to be done with this.
All right, we got our Chemback bottles, our goo tabs, our D's nuts, some electrolytes, mask, 100% Speedcraft glasses, Bounty Triple X shoes, liquid goo gels, regular goo gels, gloves, jersey, helmet, spares, stuff, you name it.
Let's go. All right, here we go. Race day, Pan Am Champs, let's do it.
Let's go, Caleb, let's go.
Let's go, Caleb, keep it steady, let's go, champ.
That's top 10, Caleb, let's go, stay in there. Eighth, Caleb, eighth, keep it steady, stay on him.
Let's go, Caleb. Let's go, Caleb. Let's go, let's go, let's go. That's top five, Caleb, right up there. Let's go.
Here's another quick race report from Indianapolis. Ended up sixth overall. Mediocre start, but moved up pretty quick and kind of settled into the top 10 group. Rode my way from 15th into the top 10, into the top 8. All of a sudden, I was working in the group for fighting for second. I was starting to get a little more comfortable, and unfortunately I had a small crash. That was totally my fault. That caused me to lose contact with that front group, and I just never got my mojo back, and unfortunately never made contact again. And then finished up sixth with one guy catching me on the very last climb.
At least two.
Oh my goodness. All right, day after the race. Last final day in Puerto Rico here. Last final day, you know what I mean. We're gonna do 50 miles on the mountain bikes, 8 to 10,000 feet of climbing. It's already raining, and there's a mountain that translates to the tits. So we're going to Titty Mountain.
Paul, are we thirsty enough to drink the water that says boil for 3 minutes before drinking?
Not yet.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I think we're almost to the top. It is.
20%.
We got some banana trees. Got some free ride food.
Well, I'm pretty sure this is the top of them. But there's a gate in front of those tetas.
Well, Paul split off to take the road back. I tried to find the trail called the Knife, but turns out my routing was not so good. Had been some dead ends, and it was bad. So I had to turn around. I'm going.
All right, I had one last meal of rice and beans. Wash the bike. Pack it up.
Always wash your bike before you pack it so you don't scratch it. And also, always let your bike dry before.
Packing up. Time to hit the road back to the airport hotel.
No. They're gonna tie it down. They're not just gonna leave it.
I should just leave it like that.
How you feeling about this?
Should have shipped your bike flights.
I think I almost just got recruited by the Puerto Rican army. I walked outside and there's like 30, 40 people lined up and they're like, what's your priority? I said, I don't know. They're like, you better check. I'm like, what? Yeah, he goes, where are you going? I'm like, you're going to MEPS? I'm like, I don't know what that is. Probably not. They're like, where are you going? I'm like, Philadelphia. Like, they started laughing like, oh man, you almost just got recruited.
So yeah, I'm back home. Trip was awesome. So many new experiences. Great racing. So much good time with friends. Just, man, to be back doing semi-normal things just felt so good. And yeah, glad to be back racing internationally and come away with some great results. Fayetteville up next. And a big thank you to Julia Bielich, our team director, Jason Jablonski, Kyle, our mechanic, and everybody else who and all of our sponsors who made this happen.